Coming up next, SPNN takes us back to 1999 with their series, Quarter Notes, Jazz from the Artist's Quarter. In this episode, Mark Elf.
Mark Elf, a nonstop bebop guitar player from the jazz capital of the world, the Big Apple, New York City. An outstanding, hard-driving, hard-swinging cat, and something of a throwback to the beatnik era. He's got a cool little mustache that turns up on the ends like Salvador Dali. He's also a fine businessman. He has his own CD label, Gen Bay Records, several CDs out on that label. He's traveled around the world with some of the heavyweights of jazz, including Dizzy Gillespie and the Heath Brothers and Joe Henderson. Mark Elf, a fine guitar player, as you'll see. Check him out. Thank you. Jerome Kern was one of the great American popular composers, and most of the great American songbook composers loved jazz. They loved to hear what the jazz artists did with their songs, the new inventions that they came up with. Cole Porter and Irving Berlin and Rodgers and Hart and George Gershwin, certainly, and Harold Arlen and Willard Robeson. They all loved jazz, but Jerome Kern is an exception. He hated jazz, and he hated what the jazz guys did to his music. So it's very ironic that Jerome Kern's All the Things You Are is one of the most played songs in the jazz repertory, and nobody plays it the way he wanted it played, because Jerome Kern wanted you to play the notes as written. And you'll see that Mark Elf doesn't play the notes as written. He uses it as a springboard for his own invention. And that's what jazz is all about. It's almost never about playing the notes as written. It's about using the notes and the harmonies and the chord patterns as a springboard for your own flights of fancy. And that's what Mark Elf does with another Jerome Kern tune that's often played by jazz cats, Nobody Else But Me. And I guarantee you, the late, great Mr. Kern would have hated this version, but it's pretty swinging, pretty hip. Thank you. Mark Elf really entered the jazz big leagues when he went to Europe, when Dizzy Gillespie tapped him to tour with him in Germany and France and Greece. And Dizzy Gillespie, of course, was one of the greatest trumpeters in jazz and one of the innovators of bebop. Another one of the great jazz trumpeters who sadly died young and who was a great innovator in bebop was the late Clifford Brown. And you're going to hear Mark Elf and the band do Brownie Speaks, a Clifford Brown composition, and an instant arrangement right on the stand. They made it up as they went along. And Brownie Speaks features some fine mid-song breaks, fine cadenza by Mark on guitar, and some excellent exchanges with Kenny Horst, the drummer and the proprietor of the Artist Quarter. Thank you. Welcome back, the man in black, and we don't mean Johnny Cash, but Mark Elf wearing his trademark black hat. And he's going to do a great bar song. One of the pitfalls of being out in the bars all the time and having that bar lifestyle like myself is that smoke gets in your eyes. This is a fine classic ballad about romance in the bar. Smoke gets in your eyes. And Mark is going to do a thing with a pitch divider on this tune. Sometimes his guitar playing sounds pianistic, but on this selection, it will sound more like a celeste or a music box. He gets those high tones dividing the pitch, reminiscent of the late great gentle giant of the guitar, Tal Farlow, who's perfected this technique. Here's Mark Elf, very subtle, Kenny Horst on the brushes, and the lovely ballad from the bars, Smoke Gets in Your Eyes. Thank you. It's break time, everybody, and everybody needs a break tune, and Mark Elf has one of the most common and popular break tunes going for him. Tune favored by Art Blakey and scads of other bebop and hard bop players, and he's gonna burn on it here. You know, after getting his big break with Dizzy Gillespie, Mark went on to play with Jimmy Heath and Percy Heath and Hank Jones and record with Joe Henderson and play with the Marsalis brothers, and you can see why on this set closer. It's gonna rock ya. It's gonna be some hard charging stuff, and you know, so much that you see on TV is jive. This number is all the way live. Thank you. Now for a change of pace, we go to Brazil and the Bossa Nova, and a classic by the number one composer of the Bossa Nova, Antonio Carlos Jobim. It's the bass player's choice, Tom Lewis, and he came up with No More Blues. And while we're in South America, in Brazil, we might mention that after about 25 years as a professional musician, Mark Elf's first CD with the Mark Elf Trio came out on a label called Alerce and was recorded in Chile, in Santiago, Chile. So jazz is an international language, and sometimes it has some strange little sentences. And it's funny that a guy from New York would make his first album in Chile, but whatever, it put Mark Elf on his path. It got a lot of radio play, and that's what helped bring him some years later to St. Paul's Artist Quarter. Now, No More Blues by Antonio Carlos Jobim. Thank you. One of the time-honored practices in bebop is to take a classic American popular song and take its chord changes and make a new song, put a new melody on top of the same chord pattern. And that's what Mark Elf did with this next selection, Trichinometry. It's the title track from his CD, Trichinometry. Here it is right here on the Gen Bay Records label. Mark Elf is joined on the CD by some of the top young talents in jazz today, people like Christian McBride on bass and Nicholas Payton on trumpet. And he also has some older cats who are quite distinguished too, like Grady Tate playing drums and singing. So Trichinometry on the Gen Bay Music label, Mark Elf's own label. This is the title track. It's based, as he'll tell you, on Lover Come Back to Me. Trichinometry. Thank you.
Thank you. That was Trichinometry. And I'd like to do a beautiful Harold Arlen composition that I'm going to be recording on my next record, so I'd like to practice it a little bit, see, before I go into the studio. And this is really a great tune called Blues in the Night. My mama done told me. I hope you enjoy this.
Mark Elf has more chops than a butcher shop, but there's more to technique than playing fast and showing off and being flashy. Mark Elf can also be tender and poetic and really caress a ballad. The other side of technique, letting the song sing itself.